Alright, Shalom. First off, I'm going to start by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Raka, HaKodesh. And I want to give double honor to my apostles and bishops of Great Millstone that taught me this truth, and citations to the hopeful elect of the nation of Israel, which consists of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and the Israelites, which are scattered all around the world amongst the other nations, which we refer to as the Israelite foreigners. Shalom. This is Brother Kassab back at it again, Lord willing, with another edifying lesson. Okay, what I wanted to go into is adultery, all right, amongst these different camps. You know, these camps, they be having women in their congregation, all right? And like the scriptures say, it's best that a woman learn at home, all right? And women are to keep silent in the churches, man, okay? That's 1 Corinthians 14 and verse, I believe, 33, or one of those verses in chapter 14. Okay, let your woman keep silence in the churches. Apostle Paul also wrote in the book of 1 Timothy, I believe it's either 1 or 2 Timothy, that a woman is not supposed to teach, but to be in silence and under subjection. All right, we know in Genesis, the 3rd chapter, the scriptures say the woman, all right, her desire shall be towards her husband, and he shall rule over thee, roughly paraphrasing. All right, we know that the Most High said what? The tabernacle of the Most High is with men. And in the book of Proverbs, he said, unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of men. All right, when you read the scriptures where the Most High said, speak unto the children of Israel, the Hebrew word for children is ban, which means sons. All right, because it's always meant for the sons to be the priest. As the scriptures say, we shall be a nation of kings and priests. Okay? Now, there's adultery going on in these other camps because they bring these women around, man. All right? The scriptures say in Job 39 and 17, the Most High deprived them of wisdom. We know that women are irrational. They don't think with logic most of the time. All right, they're driven by emotion. Okay, and that's not bad because that's the way they were designed. That's their makeup. All right, that's not to knock them. That's just the way they are. But it really starts with us as men, and that's why the scriptures say in Micah the 3rd chapter, these heads of Jacob. It, you know, you're supposed to know these scriptures. You're supposed to know the order. All right, women ain't supposed to be around different men. All right, in the congregation, you know, y'all having councils and y'all discussing matters. You know, politics amongst the congregation of men, and then you got women in the midst of that. Okay, you know, you got, for example, over there in IUIC. All right, there was a situation that's going, I'd say, viral amongst Israel. All right, and their leader, Bishop Nate, was going into it on the adultery. How you had a woman that was married and the man that was married. All these people that's married are in IUIC. All right, the man that's married and the woman that's married to another man. They're all in IUIC. All right, but here it is behind closed doors. Those two individuals, they're lusting at each other, and they're snooping around, sending freak sexting. You know, they call it sexting. All right, sending explicit text messages towards each other. You know, and talking dirty towards. You know, flirting with each other, you know, that's off. That's going off, man. That's adultery. Okay? And You know, you had Bishop Nate, he jokingly said, oh, I like to see these text messages. Some dumb shit he said. All right. Which, you know, which goes to show you, man, these you know, some of these camps, they ain't right, man. The leaders ain't right and they ain't right, you know. And that's why we here at Great Millstone, we don't have women amongst us, because we know women bring about confusion, man. All right. Women divide, man. Women divide. And destroy, man. Okay? And our leaders, our apostles and elders, and bishops, they already been through that. They seen it happen already. So they know how, you know, things can get when women get involved amongst, you know, this thing of ours. You know, this should be a manly thing. All right, because the Most High is only dealing with men. All right, the woman should learn at home, and like scripture say, let her ask her husband at home, because it is a shame for them to speak in the church, man. And then women, you know, most of these women, they always want to do something that we do. Okay, they always want to be a part of what we doing. They follow us, right? But They don't know their boundaries, man. Another reason why it says the Most High have imparted to them wisdom. And that's why it says just leave them at home. Just don't even bring them around. Right? You shouldn't be bringing a woman around. Different brothers. All right? Because that promotes adultery. Okay? It's best that you keep your woman away from the brotherhood, away from the fellowshipping, away from the events, for the most part, man. Away from when we're doing the work. Okay. You know, you might have a beautiful woman. You don't want to bring your woman around brothers and brothers, you know, a bunch of, you know, men. Because, like I said, that you know, somebody might lust after her. You know, we in the flesh. We're not perfect. All right, we're not under the new covenant yet. We're in the flesh, man. We're under grace. Okay, the new covenant will be able to keep the law, statutes, commandments perfectly. All right. But yeah, man, that's why if you're amongst these camps and they, you know, your leaders is going off like this, it's best for you to leave. All right. I also wanted to touch on another situation where you had the head of the Sakari camp. He was talking shit about his teacher, which is our teacher, you know, because he learned from our, he came out of GMS. He learned from our teacher, which is the apostles. Okay. He's talking shit about Apostle Tahar. All right. And like the elder brother out there in South Carolina, Manata Zagba, he did a video on it saying that, you know, he's mad because everybody got on him about that Hoover Crip nonsense, or that Hoover gangbanging shit that he was pushing on No Jumper with Adam 22. All right. He's mad about that because, you know, brothers rebuked him on that because you're being double-minded. All right, you still conforming to this world, but then you got people that's newly coming into this. They don't know what's going on. They watching guys like Sakari, IUIC, ISUBK. You know, it's another group, man. I would never forget what this dude, one of the dudes from ISUBK, said. This dude gonna say John the Baptist was a plate of rice and fish, was a bottle of a shot of whiskey. Yo, man, these guys are out of their fucking mind, disrespecting John the Baptist. You know, when the Lord bigged them up, you know. But I always gotta bring it up because that shit, I still can't believe this dude said that, man. That was the one of the craziest things I ever heard. My time being in the truth. All right. But yeah, you know, got these different groups like Believers of the Way, Adam Abbott. Those are all Johnny Come Lately camps. All right, they want to do their own thing. They don't want to follow the order. You know, they don't want to follow the true doctrine. All right, they don't want to affiliate with us because we had a true doctrine. Okay, they want to do their own thing. Right, and they want to go about teaching damnable heresies, man. All right, but you had Alizar. He's talking shit about Pastor Har, saying that he's jealous of Nate. All right, why would Pastor Har be jealous of Nate, man? You know, you got nothing but adultery going on in IUIC, man. And that's why the scriptures say what that they did that congregation is. Scriptures talk about these churches, man. You know, and they got temples made with hands. The Most High don't dwell with temples made with hands. The Most High said them temples ain't nothing but harlot houses, man. And guess what? They got nothing but a bunch of harlots up in there, man. You know, a bunch of adulteresses, man, and a bunch of adulterers. All right. So why would we be jealous of IUIC when they got a 501c3 charter? They leader sold out. Yeah, he could be making millions. He could be worth millions. The dude was a cop. The dude was a fucking officer. He was a pig. Then he sold out. All right? So why would we be... Why would Apostle Hall be jealous of that man? There's nothing to be jealous about. All right? We don't care about how many numbers he got. Most of them guys don't know the scriptures. They don't know the breakdowns, man. Okay? And most of them guys, they're not compelled to be teachers. You know, their leaders just let them do whatever they want. Okay? You know, us here at Great Millstone, beginning with the leadership, we held to a standard, man. It's, you know, the apostles encourage us, you know, to do videos. And if you don't, you're going to be fucking... You're gonna be scolded, man. Rightfully so. You gotta put your hand to the plow. You gotta work in this thing, man. All right, and that's the spirit of Yahweh Bashimi Al Shai, because Yahweh Shai said, "Labor, man. The labor is no labor, man." Okay, but yeah, it is. We ain't envying these other camps. We ain't envying what they got or what they do, because at the end of the day, it's not about what you got, about what you do. It's about glorifying Yahweh Bashimi Al Shai. Fuck you. Fuck me. Fuck any of us, man. It's about Yahweh Bashimi Al Shai. It ain't about you or me, any of us. Guys get big-headed and think it's about them, man. All right? But like I said, man, see, we got these new brothers coming in. New sisters, new believers, new members of the faith, and they watching these videos, and you guys ain't nothing but stumbling blocks into them. And if they get caught out there, like we always say, then, you know, it was meant for you to just be, you know, it's just meant for you to fall into that ditch. Like scripture say, the blind lead the blind. Both of them shall fall into the ditch. Alright, so that's all that is. If you led by the blind, you're just gonna fall in a ditch. That's the bottom line, man. And you know, we telling you, don't listen to these guys, man. We're not saying that so that you could come, so just because you could come listen to us. We don't care about numbers, man. We care about the elect. You know, we used to say about the Heavenly Father and His Son. We used to say about the kingdom of heaven and getting up out of here, seeing the downfall of your enemies. You know, you used to say about desiring righteousness in the earth. Then leave those groups, man. Don't watch those other groups, man. Don't watch IUIC. Don't watch Sakari. Don't watch ISUPK. All right. Watch the sincere men. Watch the beginning with the Apostle Nels, Great Millstone on down. Watch the men of Great Millstone. watch the men of that's teaching like-minded doctrines. All right. So I'm gonna leave you with that. Lord willing, this rant was edifying. All right. I'm driving. I'm in transit. All right. So with that, I'm gonna say shalom.